What's the motherfucking deal, Sauce Nation? It's your boy Ed Honcho, and this is a Sauce Sports special. If you're not familiar with Sauce Sports is a Houston homer channel. So we're talking all sports, but we're talking only Houston. And if you don't know what the Know Your Texas series is, we're talking about number 2 to number 99. And then we're going to put all the extras who came and went at the end. And we on number 99 right now. So y'all know what that be. Like I said, I told y'all I was going to give y'all 100 motherfucking videos, okay? This isn't video number 99. I still got buku videos to drop. But like I said, I still got about 12 more to come out. I think this is video number 88. We'll see. I lost count. Like I said, I'm just trying to get y'all this off. I shouldn't even do this video. Man, y'all know who we talking about. We talking about number 99. The motherfucking man. The motherfucking myth. The motherfucking monster. The motherfucker. We talking about JJ. Motherfucking White. He gets two motherfuckers. I gave Clowney a motherfucker. He upgraded to a motherfucker. JJ get two motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying? Well, I know a lot of y'all, like I said, I'm finna go into a laundry list of accolades and all those things. Y'all know the Know Your Texans is about showing love, is about just kind of touching on all the things that these guys have done up until this point in their career, and that we're continuing to wish progress and positive, and just spreading love, man. Just throwing love all over the place. Ain't nothing but love for the Texans, man. That's all I got. So this is just my way of giving back to the, giving my sauce back to the Texans. So anyway, with that being said, we're talking about number 99, J.J. Watt, defensive end for your Houston Texans, a 6'5", 295-pound motherfucker born March 22nd, 1989, and that's why he's the greatest, because he's a damn 80s baby. I'm not going to say it again. Anyway, I'm going to stop fucking with y'all. That was out of Wisconsin, man. If I told you I knew where he was from, Waukesha? Like I said, I know y'all know because I know y'all a bunch of J.J. Watt heads out there. So I know y'all can bring Waukesha, Wisconsin. Waukesha, Wisconsin. Somebody going to come along this and somebody going to drop some sauce on this. So drop that in the comments. Man, if you watching this video and you haven't subscribed, you are not an official ingredient. Okay, you want to become an ingredient in the sauce, you got to subscribe, then you got to drop a comment below. You can like, you can dislike, I don't care, you don't have to agree with me, you know what I'm saying? We all got opinions, but like I said, you just subscribe, become an ingredient, drop your comments below. Anyway, let's where do we start? Let's talk college. Okay, so it was a 2010 first team All-American, 2010 All Big Ten. Racked up 101 tackles, 36.5 tackles for a loss, 11 and a half sacks, and one INT. Now, started out at Central Michigan trying to go on as a tight end, I believe, then eventually walked on at Wisconsin. So, you know, don't always believe that, you know, walk-ons ain't about their work. A person who's willing to walk on usually has more heart and drive than somebody who it was given to. I mean, they're trying to go out. They're willing to overcome. They're willing to fight for it. So, you see, JJ got more drive than, shit, a four-wheel drive. I don't fucking know. The motherfucker's a monster, you know. So, anyway, we know about last year, and he came back a little bit too early, and then we'd be like, damn. But y'all do realize he's coming back to that number one defense. So a lot of those turnovers and things that we weren't racking up, oh, they're coming back. Oh, please believe that. They're coming back. And then when you have to respect the fact that JJ's on this side, Clowney's on that side, or they could be anywhere. JJ and Clowney, they move around so much, so there's no way of really just being able to shut them down and say, okay, well, we're going to do this or do that. And they're going to be everywhere. And I'm so excited. This is the thing I'm the most excited for, just seeing JJ and Clowney demolish people all fucking year long. It's going to be great. Anyway, so let's just talk about a couple of the things he's done in the NFL. You know, he hasn't been that great. He's been okay in the NFL. Bullshit, this motherfucker's been a beast. All right, so taken in the first round, 2011 with the 11th pick. I don't know how the fuck he got out. He wasn't even the top 10 pick, and this motherfucker's he's a legend. Anyway, ran a 4.84 coming out of college. 379 tackles. All right, 76 sacks. That's fucking ridiculous right there. This man's got plenty more to play. Already got 76 sacks. Anyway, 45 pass defense. This motherfucking corners and safeties that don't see that shit in their fucking career, dog. 15 forced fumbles, one INT, five touchdowns, because he was playing receiver, he was doing it all. Motherfucker, he does it all, dog. Like, are y'all not excited? Are y'all not excited for the return of JJ? I'm excited, dog, because like, I'm not the biggest JJ Watt fan. I love that defense. I'm not the biggest JJ Watt fan. I like JJ. I like JJ a lot, but he's not my favorite Texan. But I know what he's capable of, and bringing that back to that number one defense, like I say, statistically and all that other shit, well, we gonna get all the things in accords when JJ come back. Everything gonna be just like it's supposed to be, and we finna see that real soon. So anyway, let's talk about it. Two-time sack leader, three-time defensive player of the year, first-team All-Pro, four fucking Pro Bowls, won the Burt Bell Award, is always in the MVP conversation as a defensive player. Fuck a quarterback, okay? It's the easiest thing to do. Everything depends on you. They give quarterbacks these stats they don't deserve. You know, a lot of that to be yak yards. They didn't get that yak. They might have made that pass. The receiver got that yak. That ain't on the QB, but they get accredited for all of that. Man, what Watt did a couple of years back when he didn't win it, y'all was so fucking devastated, because that lets you know the NFL is full of bullshit. Because that's a once-in-a-lifetime once-in-a-generation player. You're not going to see stats like that again. It's going to be, if he's not doing it, it's going to be a long time. It ain't going to be none of these other dudes that y'all love so much and want to try to put up there. They may get sacks. They may do those things. But they don't put together the full spectrum of defense that this dude plays. But anyway, like I say, man, I got to stir the sauce fast because I got to bring Elmo Flavor. But I can sit here, like I said, just like I could talk about Jadeveon all day, I could talk about Watt all day, man, get excited because I just think about them two motherfuckers just crushing heads. But anyway, that being said, man, you already know what it is. SauceSports.com. Join the Flavor Forum. If you ain't in the Flavor Forum, you tripping. You ain't dripping, you tripping. Anyway, with that being said, man, look. Go to SauceSports.com. Join the Flavor Forum. Let's chop it up. That's where Sauce Nation, that's the home of Sauce Nation. Yeah, we build it up off the YouTube, but hey, that's going to be the new home of Sauce Nation, SauceSports.com. There's some stuff going on YouTube and some things, some changes that I've been noticing, but you know, we ain't going to get all of that. That ain't the video for this. So go to SauceSports.com. That's why we got that. So join the forum. We're going to talk all that good shit. Then after you get, if you done that, man, go hit that shop button. Go get that South Sports shirt. I'm going to be dripping in my South Sports shirt later on today when the game starts in a couple hours here. So I got to bring more flavor. I still got like 10, 12 videos to do. I got to bring more flavor. I told y'all I was going to give y'all that 100. I'm going to give y'all 100. So stay tuned. Anyway, like I said, you'll see all the socials. Y'all see all the South socials. South Sports HTX on the Twitter. South Sports on the Facebook page. Trying to get that to 100 likes. Honcho Saucy on Xbox. If y'all want to run a game, man, hit me. It ain't got to just be sports. We can run a co-op. We can run a competitive, whatever type of shit. Like I said, I've been doing various different things. South Sports is the channel. Sauce Sports is the place. Y'all are the freshest ingredients in the motherfucking world, so I know y'all got plenty of fucking sauce to drop on. Man, it's an unlimited motherfucking, it's unlimited sauce for JJ. So go ahead and drop that shit in the comments below. I'm looking forward to seeing what y'all got to say, how y'all feel. If y'all excited about the return of JJ, I'm not worried about that back. I'm just want to see that attack. Oh, man, I'm telling y'all. Anyway, with that being said, man, I got to get up out of here because I got more flavor to bring. That flavor, it's just, JJ got that unique sauce. Anyway, with that being said, man, deuce up. Y'all be cool. Like, y'all be cool, Sauce Nation. SauceSports.com. Join the Flavor Forum. I'm not going to say it again.